Welcome to our April Board of Education meeting. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Paul O'Brien.
Here.
John Green.
Here.
Scott Latham.
Here.
Here.
In the event of an emergency, visitors are advised that they may exit this room from the one side door which leads directly into the parking lot. In the event of an emergency, everyone is asked to move away from the building and do not attempt to leave in your automobile since this may cause traffic problems and block incoming emergency vehicles.
Dr. Moore, I think the first thing is going to be the student presentation, so I'll let you talk about it if you'd like.
We have some students with us tonight that are going to present. I got a chance to go see their play, which and it was wonderful. You guys did a fantastic job. Who am I going to introduce that's going to... Okay, go on up. you drew the short straw, so they sent you up.
Thank you again for having us. They're very excited to perform for you all tonight. And our production was a great success. They had one show on Friday, March 31st, and another show on Saturday, April 1st, and they were great community events. So many people came out to see it. And they're just going to perform a couple of the songs for you today. So I'm going to send them on up. All right.
Instead of less, maybe we fix the game with
So, you know what, just while everyone's getting settled back, I'd like to thank Mrs. Kennedy, Mrs. Grathwell, Mrs. Hilary for working with the students for the last few months. And you all did such a fabulous job. The first Broadway play I ever went to with my mom in fourth grade was Annie. And I brought my daughter to see it on Saturday. You all did an amazing job. So thank you, everybody.
Yeah. Schoolwork or stuff to do at it home, so you can feel free to leave the meeting if you'd like to.
Why don't we? We'll give you a couple minutes so that you can meet up with your parents and go. You don't have to sit here.
Thank you for coming, guys.
Thanks for coming, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
When I was in elementary school, I was terrified.
My son did Into the Woods. He was Prince Charming with his princess was Mark Zepparini's daughter.
Oh, that's cool. That's neat.
Thank you, Mrs. Grathwell and Mrs. Kennedy.
Really,
it was terrific.
Talking.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's comfortable in front of a crowd, maybe by the edge of a crowd.
Yeah. And I certainly can't sing and dance at all.
Okay, that brings us to our first hearing of visitors. At this time, we request that questions and comments be kept to agenda items only. Does anyone care to address the board at this time? Ladies? No? Okay, that brings us to our consent agenda, which includes the minutes for approval of our minutes of our regular board meeting of March 22nd and the budget meeting of April 5th. It also includes our financial matters, the schedule of our bills, the treasurer's report from March, the monthly budget status report from March, some transfers, the extra classroom activity funds. We have health contracts with another school district, and we are surplusing some pianos. Also included in the consent agenda are the CSE recommendations. Are there any questions or comments on the consent agenda? Is there a motion to accept?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. That brings us to every year we have to do a tax anticipation note, and I'm certainly not going to read all of this.
Everybody
has a copy of it. What it does is it allows us to borrow monies that we need to operate before the tax levies come in from the town. How is that for a simple way to put it? And we do it year after year, and I like to comment that because we're in such a good financial position, we borrow less and less. Thank you, Mr. Scheid.
Thank you to our taxpayers and voters.
Absolutely. Is there a, what is the a maximum amount on this one going to, oh, okay, this is not going to exceed $5 million. I have to be perfectly honest with you. It was up as high as $14 million at one point. The tax anticipation. Yeah, so, yeah. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Roll call. Paulette Frias?
Yes.
John Crean?
Yes.
Brian Tobin?
Here.
Scott Latham?
Yes.
Thank you, Patty. Old business, Dr. Morrow, about...
So we touched base with Virtual Enterprise. They actually should be pulling in almost now. Their bus was delayed till 7, coming back from their national competition in the city. So we don't really know how they did yet because they were on their way back on the bus. But they're going to come in and present on the 24th for us so that, you know, we can share with everybody a little bit of what they do. They're a wonderful organization, and I've been lucky enough every year that I've been here to see them in a competition. So I've gotten to sit where the judges sit and actually watch them present.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's really neat, you know. And then there's a whole showcase of everybody's company in, say, you know, this one was at CW Post, so it was in their field house. So everybody's company was set up. You get to walk around and see all the different companies from all the different school districts. And then there's a set time that you go and present, and I happen to be able to see that too. So it'll be great for them to come in and present to you, and it'll be interesting to see how professional they are, and it'll be a nice experience. Yes.
We can roll right into the superintendent's report then, please.
So I just wanted to thank everybody, you know, the community input, Chuck, all of our administrators, you know, and quite honestly, many of our employees in other areas that help work on the budget. You know, we're not a big district, so when we put our budget together, it's very much on a granular level where you'll have, you know, people in a classroom asking for certain things to help put a budget together. And so I just want to thank everybody for it, because I think we, you know, in a year where you read so much about how much more was given to school districts, and there was a 14% increase in costs and the cost of living increase, and we got very, very little. So putting together a budget this year, especially as some of our opportunities to utilize money from federal grants end, you know, it was a little bit harder than some people think. So thank you to everybody who helped put it together. I think it's a great budget, and I'm looking forward to, you know, our budget vote next month. Spring sports. It doesn't feel like spring sports out there. I was out there today. It's freezing. But it's really great to see everybody out on the fields, especially now as they're really starting to green up a little bit. You know, there was a track meet going on today. We've had tennis matches, baseball games, softball games. It's really nice to see everybody involved. You know, other student happenings. Our robotics team left today for the World Championships in Houston, which they've qualified for second year in a row. I think it's their 7th time in their history qualifying for it. You know, it's also great to just see all the different activities that are going on with kids. You know, we're coming down towards the end of the year, so you're seeing kids coming in their school sweatshirts from the schools they choose to participate, or the branches in the military they've joined. And, you know, it's a nice celebratory time of the year, and I'm looking forward to the last quarter and everything that comes along with it.
Thank you. Thank you for that report. That brings us to personnel. We have a whole host of things here, and I'll Patty, you let me know if I get them wrong, okay?
Okay.
All righty. Leaving the district, Kristen Derrigan's doing family medical leave effective June 1st, 2023 through October 27th, 2023. 11.2, we're not taking action on tonight, right, Patty?
No, but we have another.
Right, I've got that one here on the addendum. Then we have a whole host of election workers that will be working during the election for the budget vote. I don't think I need to read them all. We have a coach for our second junior high softball team. We have a mentoring, Nicole Tejada with Jason Wesnowski. We have some substitute teachers, substitute custodians, substitute teacher assistants and teacher aides, baseball and softball scorekeepers, and entering the district full-time permanent is Suzanne Young, a teacher's aide, effective April 24th, 2023. And then we've got three contract amendments for Anthony Dragone, Charles Scheid, and Anthony Morrow. Did I get them all, Patty?
Yep, you got them all.
They're dead. Is there a motion to accept the superintendent's personnel recommendations?
So moved.
Second? Yes. Brian, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, we need to vote on the BOCES budget. At least we're not having to have a special meeting this year for the first time in many, many years.
I scheduled it on the same day. That's right.
BOCES adopts their budget, and then the component school districts are asked to vote on their budget. I think that, and I've looked it over briefly, I didn't spend a lot of time on it. I don't think it's an unreasonable budget. We should do that one first, and then we do the board members for BOCES. Would anyone like to make a motion on the BOCES 2023-2024 administrative budget?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Well, there's 6 people looking for 5 seats on the BOCES board. I know Ann McAsee from Sag Harbor's been on for a long time, as has William Miller from Longwood. I don't know the others, so I'm going to ask you guys your opinion on this. Guys?
So we have to eliminate one of these tonight?
Yes.
Can we just abstain? I don't know what... I don't...
I guess we could. We could.
I don't know enough to make
it. We could vote on one. We could vote on two.
I don't know enough to decide.
Right.
Because I don't know any of these folks.
I don't disagree with you. Can we just put in an abstention, Patty?
I guess we can.
I guess that's what we shall do.
Okay.
I mean, I'm sure there are other, there are people who know them well and are more involved in this, but I don't feel that I'm knowledgeable enough to exclude any of these people.
I agree with you. I mean, we know when the others expire, like Brian Mealy, because we know him. Right, the
East
ones,
End
from somebody was local, we knew that they were kind of looking out.
The one from Sag Harbor, do you know her?
Ann McAsee's the only one I know by name, and I personally don't know. I know she's been on the BOCES board for quite a while. But do we have to make a motion to not vote for anybody?
Come up before.
We just take no action at all.
I don't remember ever having to eliminate anybody.
Yeah, I don't remember.
There'd be 5, we'd say yes, so, and thanks for doing
well. Sometimes there's been like 2 for, there's been 5 for 2 seats, and we recognize names or something like that.
All right. If you guys want to vote, you can, but I
vote for Ann McAsee.
I guess no action.
Why don't we just... I move we vote for Ann McAsee.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. There we go, Patty. Is there any new business? Finance Committee report, Mr. Tobin.
Nothing.
Building Committee?
Nothing to report. I know the process is in place to get some boilers, but that's a... beginning of next year or so?
First, we wait for the budget vote.
Okay.
Because it's got to be, we can't take any action on any of that.
Right.
Once, if the budget vote, if it's approved for us to use, capital project work for that, then we would put everything forward to the state and wait for the approval process from them.
And that's a 6-month, it's a bit of a...
That's running almost 12 months now since the pandemic.
We don't have a cold winter next year.
The expectation is that next summer we should hopefully have everything in place financially and from the state.
And we're going to do it in stepwise, right? Yeah.
We're working with our architect on that. He believes we should do a building at a time. I wanted to do a boiler at a time. He tells me that mechanically that's
once they're in there, do the whole building. All right.
So, and he knows a lot more about it than us. So we'll work with him.
So that's the big issue for building and grounds right now, is getting these things done. All right.
Is the $3.5 million, is that both buildings though?
Yes.
Okay.
It turns out when I got the initial cost and told you they were about $1 million each, they were. That was at the height of the pandemic, so they're actually a little less expensive than that now. They're probably $700,000 or $800,000 each.
And I guess also stress that because of the good financial situation we're in, and the in the support of our voters, we do not have to bond. We have the money in reserve, so there'll be no tax increase.
There's no impact to taxes at all.
Major improvements, because we've been allowed over the years to put monies away for these kinds of things.
Yes.
I mean, the elementary boilers are in considerably better shape than this building, I think, because it's a much newer building.
Elementary boiler is the one
boiler down there is leaking.
That's the one we're having most of the problems with.
Oh, that's interesting.
And it's 20, almost 25 years old, he told me.
But the ones here are like 100.
The ones here, I think, are, he thought, between 30 and 40. They've been replaced, and, you know, ultimately, and he's not the first person that's told us, the hardest part of fixing our boilers is getting pieces to fix it. You know, no one's making pieces for the boilers we have anymore. You know, it's kind of like when you get an Apple product, you know, in a year, it doesn't work with anything. It's out of date. You got to get a new one, you know. So believe it or not, though, right now, the boiler we've had the most problem with is one of the elementary ones. Luckily, we have dual boilers, so it hasn't impacted us that negatively.
And a mild winter.
Yeah, yeah.
We have two over there.
We have two massive boilers in both buildings. Yeah, and they're both they're all dual fuel boilers, so they work both on oil and on gas. In that building, we have to switch when they tell us to switch because the state has conservation times.
Right.
So they'll tell us to come off natural gas and go to oil. In this building, we only have to do it, you know, when we choose to. We don't do it as often, especially because oil has just been a lot more expensive right now.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Policy, Scott?
Nothing.
That brings us to our second hearing of visitors. At this time, we'll take any kind of questions or comments you have to direct at us. Does anybody care to address the board now? You got to come up to the mic, Jess, sorry. It's not that far of a walk. Well, we want you to come up and say it so it's on record.
Jessica Michaels, I just wanted to say the mirror in the women's bathroom right here in the hallway looks nice.
It was nice to hear positive.
I'm sorry. and I think we need the bathrooms in the elementary school redone.
Fair enough.
Put it on the list, John. Not an unfair request. Anybeth? Marta? Okay. Brings us to our board member commentary. I'm guessing Mr. Mullins out playing some kind of sports.
Yes.
I'm going to give you the next meeting dates before I do our board member commentary. On May 3rd, we have a budget meeting and a work session. It's not where any action takes place. It's a state-mandated. Am I getting this right?
Yes.
Because it has to be, we have to act on something that we've already voted on, but the state makes us do it, and usually Mrs. MacArthur comes from the library to present the library budget. So that takes place on May 3rd. The budget vote is May 16th from 3 to 9 in the high school gymnasium, and our next regular Board of Education meeting will be May 24th. Board member commentary. Scott.
Just best of luck to robotics in Houston. Quite an accomplishment for a district of this size, but I had the pleasure one day of sitting in the barber chair and listening to Bob Gammon explain the robotics program to Dave's brother, your brother-in-law's brother.
Martin.
Yes. And to listen to him so proudly explain, and it almost had nothing to do with the nuts and bolts of technology, I think it would be a great, I don't know what the word would be, but great idea to have somebody interview him, like a long form interview because he gave the whole expanse of the program, the history of it, what he tries to impart to the kids. And I think it would be great to get that recorded because I'm sitting there swelling with pride under the apron, and he didn't even know I was there, and it's just really neat.
Thank you. John?
Well, a lot of neat things here for a small district. I'm always amazed because I came from up island, bigger places, and it always amazed me what is able to be accomplished in this community because everybody takes care of each other. You know, even look at these elementary school kids. I wasn't comfortable speaking in front of a crowd, certainly not singing and dancing until I was, you know, 30 years of age. And here, these are elementary kids up there, just comfortable. You can tell they reek of confidence. And that's going to serve them well for the rest of their lives, no matter what they do. And I think it's the culture here, you know. My kids were here from
K through 8, then they went to Catholic school, but they got that here, and it's still helping them, and so that's just one of the reasons that makes Southold such a special place and makes me so proud to be part of this community.
Thank you.
Well, like Scott said, we looked at the robotics team down in Houston. Quiz Bowl team is...
Quiz Bowl is going in May. They also qualified. They'll be down in New Orleans in May.
Our VE team, I mean, yeah. this is great stuff that we do here. Watching these kids perform, that was quite impressive for a group that young. You know, they look pretty comfortable up there. It's great to see the kids out in the sports, spring sports being played. And, I think we have a great facility here, seeing the teams play. And so, like John always says, it's a great little district, and we're lucky to have a community that supports us. So,
thank you. I also want to congratulate all of the teams. March, April are always those busy months where after months and months and months of hard work, the students get to showcase what they've learned. And I was really touched, you know how you were touched at the barbershop when I went down to the village of Greenport yesterday, and I saw in front of William Mills in Greenport, good luck to the robotics team. And I thought, you know, that speaks to who we are out here. We share things with Greenport, we do things together, and the people that are involved from the community in robotics is really, really amazing. The grown-ups, the former students, the alumni from Southold that are involved in it, and I'd like to invite them to a meeting like as well before the end of the year so they can show off their robot, because I know they do love to do that every year.
We invite the adults, because that's just as interesting.
Absolutely.
You know, a retired superintendent from Wading River, just because this program's so cool. And like you said, Bob is—he's very passionate.
Yes,
about
he is.
And,
yes,
and
he is.
I agree with you. I think you should be interviewed.
Absolutely. So, congratulations to all the team, all of the athletic teams out there on the courts and on the fields. We wish them all the best. I want to congratulate the valedictorian and the salutatorians. Looks like women's rule again on the East End this year. Mattituck, Southold, and Greenport. Two females from each district are representing one and two in their classes, and. They always make us very proud. All of our students make us proud. These kids tonight were amazing. As everybody said, their poise and their confidence when they get up there. And you see it in the concerts. I still come to concerts, of course, and you still see it. And it speaks to the staff, it speaks to the parents, and it speaks to the students. And I think that, you know, John said it best, that I'm certainly proud to be part of this district, and I think we get it right. I'm going to once again say budget votes May 16th. Come out and vote that day. Because it's a privilege in this country, so take advantage of that privilege. Is there a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.